I don't have a good system set up for like how much I want to charge for wild decks because it's going to be expensive for me to craft them. Whereas standard for, you know, 1500 bucks or so, I can build most standard decks.
Let the hunt begin. I will fight with honor.
We're playing against Hunter. Yeah, call got nerfed today. I'm gonna keep this, seems fine. Probably Spell Hunter.
Reporting for duty.
So we'll find out what secret this is by attacking. Hopefully it's not Wandering Monster. It's Wandering Monster. Tilt. That's a 3-4. The best way to jump in is just buy a deck. You find a cheap deck that you want to build. Start buying some packs to put the cards together for it. I built pretty much all of Tempo Mage for like 50 bucks. Which isn't terrible, especially coming from a magic background. I think I'm just using Blessing of the King. Nope, they killed my thing. I'm a liar. We're just making a bunch of dorks here. This matchup's probably pretty bad for us. I feel like Spell Hunter was favored against Paladin before, was close to favored to Paladin before the nerf, and post-nerf with Call Arms being worse, we're probably pretty poor off. They're not Spell Hunter. They have Stitch Tracker. Okay. Put a secret from my deck onto the battlefield. So this gets Noble Sacrifice, which seems okay. I can also just Blessing of the Kings this. And then kill this dork. I think I like that. I feel like I'm definitely in like damage control mode. I guess I could coin out this Righteous Protector. I'm actually gonna do that to protect my 5-3 here. But we fight. Tempo Mage is really cheap to build, Big Fat. It's one legendary card and three epics. And then the rest is rares. So I think saying a lot more than 50 is kind of disingenuous. I can do Maul plus Hero Power here. I can eat this, fight this. Seems okay. Freezing Trap. Well, that's... Get fucked for my sequencing. Yep. For justice. No, Tempo Mage plays a Lunith. Probably just gonna get raced here. Ooze is pretty brutal. I built a budget version of Tempo Mage with... You can build Tempo Mage without the epics and legendaries for, you know, 5 to 10 bucks. And again, one of the things that's great about this deck compared to coming from Magic, the budget decks in this game are much closer to being competitive than a lot of the budget decks in Magic because they're missing fewer cards the way the legendary system works. Yeah, I would definitely recommend just like jumping in and like playing it for free and not putting any dollars in before you start. Make sure you actually enjoy the gameplay before you spend any actual dollar reviews on it. You don't need a $400 database in this game. Looks like we're just getting burned out here. Yeah, we're dead. The victory is yours. Dead so. The Wandering Monster on 2 that ended up getting them the 3-4 we just never really covered from that loss to Tempo. Yeah, the number of playable commons in this game is, like, really impressive. There are a lot of playable cards that come in. Call Arms is still probably good in this mirror, even at 5. Amani Berserker seems good. I've not played any arena. Yeah, and Odium, as you've got your sub icon there, if you're not in the sub Discord, you should pop in there. There's a lot of, we have a pretty active Hearthstone channel in there where people talk about different things, give advice, can offer budget deck lists if you get start playing. We're just gonna play Berserker on 2 here. Almost certainly, because this can eat their 2/2. Looks like Murloc Paladin here. Big Fat Penis, I don't know what list you're looking at, but there's literally the Tempo Mage list that I've built and I'm playing that aren't budget. There's one legend and 3 epics in them. There's 2 glyphs and a pyroblast, and there's 1 Aluneth. Who you want me killed? That's gonna make the 2/1. Yep. Yeah, we have both Call to Arms in our hand, and I've drawn. There's only three 1 and 2s left in my deck. Oh, that's pretty frustrating. So this card grabs 3 minions that cost 2 or less from your deck and puts them into play, but I've drawn most of those cards, so kind of unfortunate. Getting brutalized. Hopefully this Call to Arms is good. We have Call to Arms into this this Bloodhoof here, which could be okay. That can get us back in this game. We started with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We started with 8 things that cost 2 or less. I wonder what the math's like on how many is optimal. All right, it gives us some recruits. I think I'm just gonna play this. Although I guess summoning a bunch of minions here is good because it triggers this a bunch. I can smack here. This fucking card, man. Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty. Hopefully one of these hits here so that way I can finish it with my Maul. Tilt. For justice. I guess I just do this, right? This gives him free reign to attack with this, though, which kind of sucks. If they have, is it Consecration deals 2 damage to every enemy? We're just gonna be completely boned here. But I don't think Murloc Paladin usually plays Consecration. Reporting for duty. But I didn't kill the 2-3 over killing the 4-3. I made the bad play because I didn't realize what I was doing. I didn't stop and think. I had it in my head that this I couldn't kill with those attacks because it started larger, but you're right, after the knife juggler hit it twice, it was definitely killable. Look at that. Knife juggler did exactly what I wanted that time. I think we're just racing at this point. I think we're in a position that we can just try and kill them. Divine Favor is pretty bad in a Paladin Mirror. They're both low on cards. They're at 12. This is gonna get me a one drop, which is exciting. That could be exciting. It's also gonna protect my smaller minions a little bit, I guess. Alright, so this is the better minion, but this I can play this turn. Honestly, I think the game's not going to come down to last to get to the 8 drop. I think I just want to play this and smash them. Like, they're at 5. Why would I take that? Can't I just kill them here? I feel like I'm supposed to just kill them. Can you explain why? Like, does everybody in chat that's saying I take the Triton, like, I feel like I'm failing to pivot a lot of these games, but like, this seems like a pretty obvious pivot. Like, this turtles up to defend the rest of my shit. Gets pretty fucking punished by that asshole, though. Pretty fucking punished by that asshole. They've already burned a silence. I think I just do this and then this, right? I wonder. Reporting for duty. Bloodhoof has been silenced. He does not make a 4-5. It's the best deck in modern humans. I don't think I want to attack here, although I guess, yeah, I'm a liar, I do. Let's just smack that. I guess this lets me kill through. Yeah, all right. Let's just crunch it up. Put this apple on your head. Put this apple on your head. It's pretty good. What's your last card? Is it also good or are you dead? Yeah, got him. All right, so even with a dead call to arms in hand there, ended up pulling that out. Feels pretty good. Feels pretty decent. I'm like, Murloc Paladin's a real deck, right? Like, that's one of the better decks in this format, right? Like, Murloc Paladin was a good deck before the nerfs, and it didn't get anything nerfed out of it, right? I don't think I want this in my opener regardless of what they're doing. They could be Zoo, so I'm going to keep Stonehill Defender. Murloc Paladin didn't play Call to Arms, right? I'm pretty sure it didn't. I remember, I think I had that built at one point and it didn't play Call to Arms. K Smith with the $5 donation. Thanks, bud. Thanks for supporting the Hearthstone content. Remember, if you're interested in seeing more Hearthstone on this stream, especially if you're a subscriber, the best way you can help me not only learn all the sweet things that Hearthstone has to offer, but help me keep doing Hearthstone consistently is donate for a favorite deck of your choice. This deck and a lot of the other decks that we've played on stream here are viewer submitted deck lists. If you're a subscriber for a $10 donation, I'll play a standard deck of your choice for a minimum of 45 minutes here on stream. I'm streaming Hearthstone every Tuesday and Thursday afternoons. In this case, evening, because I started a little bit late today. I guess it's an easy Berserker this turn. This means Zoo, I believe. Which means this Stonehill Defender should be pretty good here. We'll curve like Stonehill into Bellringer. I think Bellringer looks pretty reasonable. Do people think that card's bad? Is that a thing people think are bad? Oh, there's a taunt minion in the way, right? I know how this game works. I played before. So they can go smash, smash here. But then they don't have a way on board to kill this, which is nice. For Miracle Rogue, for Pack Slash Dust for your time and the wife. Thank you, Apprentice of Bolas. I really appreciate that. Let's put, I think Miracle Rogue is sweet. Do you have a specific Miracle list or just one of my choice? What does this do? Destroy a friendly minion, adapt twice. That's pretty good. I have a Miracle Rogue list I think I like. Do I want to? I think I want to just chain gang to keep my 5-2 alive here. There's some mechanics in Hearthstone that I wish Magic had. I don't know. The resource system in Hearthstone is definitely much more enjoyable. Sounds good. This is probably going to be my last of the day, my last set of games. We've been going for almost 8 hours now, so I think we'll wrap up this segment with Warrior and then call it. About another half hour or so playing Warrior. Paladin, whatever this class is. This is Paladin. I've played this game before. Those are some big men and women. It's Divine Shield Hammer, so it's not even very good. Yeah, I think we're pretty dead here. I'm gonna try another one. Like, what's our comeback mechanic from that point? What's our comeback mechanic? We have like a 4-5 into another 4-5, and like none of our little dudes can ever hit the board. All right, I'll go back to playing all of them out to their natural conclusion. I'll ignore the person earlier that suggested that I give up games sooner. I think I just mulligan assuming they're on Tempo Mage, which I think all of these cards are pretty bad against Tempo Mage. Is Knife Juggler an always keep? The rest of these cards are pretty bad. I kind of want to just throw all of these back. I'm just gonna throw all these back. Sand seems great. It's got a lot of good early plays.
Reporting for duty.
Yeah, the 3-2 is okay. 3-2 kills Worm nicely, which is true. Yeah, but like, I get that they weren't going to kill me, be rich, but like, what is my path to victory in the game actually look like, right? Like, they had a high health total, so I wasn't in a position to race, and none of my tools allowed me to actually check the board. I had a bunch of cards that basically said, don't die, but what is actually winning the game look like from the position I was in? That's my question. My question wasn't how do I not die. My question, I definitely had don't die figured out. Like we had a bunch of things to not die. My question is how do I actually win the game? These are all pretty rancid. I'm just gonna take a 3-3 for 4, honestly. Cold Arms did get changed to 5. Wow, that glyph must have been really bad to take a book off of it. That book must have been really bad. Oh yeah, Innkeeper has it wrong. You think I'm just supposed to blessing? I guess Tempo Mage doesn't usually play Silence, right? And that gets more damage faster. They'll use this to finish here. It's probably still worth using King next turn.
We have many secrets.
I should coin check this if I want to. I want to play Blessing, right?
No. Reporting for duty.
Yeah, so I'm down points of damage now because I didn't do this last turn, basically. Spellbender is, so I'm gonna assume it's probably bad because I've played a lot of Tempo Mage, so like they're pretty dead, right? Because, like, I get to, like, play this out at least next turn and then go ahead and use this Divine Favor.
Get down!
Favor's gonna draw us, like, infinite cards. Yeah, they play a lot of cards this turn. That's pretty good. I actually just want this. This card's not very good for us. I have another rune, that makes sense. Alright, down to 5. kill or freeze my 9/11, and they burned a Frostbolt earlier when they played the book that they got off a glyph for some reason. I'd really like to have been like a fly on the wall when they glyphed and concluded that they wanted to take book in their tempo mage deck. Why is it Tarim when I already have a Tarim in my hand? And I have like a giant monster in play that he's going to reset instead of like playing out another top minion. Can you explain why instead of just telling me definitely? Help me learn. Hey, Odium Voidbringer, thank you for the 500 bits. I appreciate that. Welcome. I think I just want to keep all of these. I guess this is pretty bad against another paladin. That's pretty bad against another paladin. I'm gonna keep the call to arms and Stonehill Defender though. That's not amazing against paladin unless we survive to get there. None will survive. So they're odds. They make a bunch of shitters. Lost was a good pickup. No, I never played World of Warcraft. We played Guild Wars growing up as an MMO a little bit, but never WoW. Yeah, but I already had a copy of that card in my hand, so that why do I need a second one? So many 1/2s. I'm going to force them to control my board here, so I'm just going to go ahead and send my points upstairs. They'll almost certainly eat two of my things this turn, though. The taunt next turn will help prop my board up a little bit, though, which is nice, and help check the flood from their hero power, since they're going to have to attack into my 1/4. Hopefully this will make another cheap taunt to help protect my board. This card is so good. This card should just be in most decks that aren't aggro. Even some aggro decks that's probably just great in. The fact that you just like randomly get to generate legendaries off of it too is kind of obscene. Out of my jungle. Feel like I've got stuff for later taking care of with like this kind of shit, so I'm just gonna grab a chain gang here for next turn. It's gonna go like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What's it called? Shaman has a lot of good taunts. There's the 7, 8 for 5, and they have the legendary 8-drop too. The light protects me. God, are they about to smash 4 idiots through this thing? Holy shit, that's good. Yes, please. Thank you, sir. You can have another. Holy shit, you can load. Of course you can load. Of course you can load it. Why wouldn't you be able to load it? The light dims, but that's why are you so good at your job, Blizzard? Yeah, I need to kill his things before he gets level up going, right? That's great, Tom. We're gonna continue curving out really nicely. Next turn, these can bump into 1/1s, then be 5/2s, and just like run them down very quickly. If they have level up here, we're in a little bit of trouble. I get to gobble my stuff up now.
Oh,
Huh. Do I want to just trade into these? I think I need to trade into these, right?
Let me think.
Is it just Steed? And I guess next turn I get to go Vinecleaver, kill this, and then start smashing their upstairs. Yeah, if they don't have a silence, we're just like in a nutso spot here. It's possible this could have baited a silence, which would be good, I think. So we're still in a terrible spot. As of this board, they have three more resources, so they're gonna get to follow up. Wow, that trade feels okay for us.
Reporting for duty.
Okay. Just gonna set this up kind of nicely. I'm definitely just in board control mode here. Maybe I should have killed one of these because of a potential second level up here. Yeah, I probably should have killed one of these because they could go hero power into level up and have 4/3s. Does Blaine Bloodhoof do anything, or is it just a vanilla 4/5? Yeah, next turn I could go Noble, Blessing, plus this, and start smashing their board down. That's actually a shortcoming in Hearthstone's interface. It's a little bit frustrating. Like, I really wish I could see what this card does if this talks about summoning. It seems kind of like a little bit of a punt that I can't do that.
Let me think.
Hey, little Marion. Catching us right at the tail end here. I'll be live tomorrow night with a bunch of magic stuff. I'm just running late tonight because where the fuck did that card come from? That is certainly something.
Reporting for duty.
How am I ever going to kill this card? Huh? How do I ever kill this card?
I wonder. For justice.
They're just gonna keep making more though.
Reporting for duty.
I guess I'm at 23, still got a little bit of health to work with here. The value this cauldron's about to generate is very, 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 very difficult to play through. Next turn, we'll see what we draw, but probably a Blessing of the King's turn.
Speak your peace.
Reporting for duty.
Noble Sack's pretty good, so we're gonna kill this for sure. Get some dorks. So I can do this, I can do this, I could do this, I could do this. And like maybe next turn we can take the board back over. This is gonna have, we've played a Stegadon, we played a Steed plus a Blessing of King, so this is gonna be, it's gonna be a big Mamma Jamma next turn. Here, catch us right at the tail end here, Boneless Berking. We're probably gonna finish this game and then play one to two more, depending on how long they take. Another 15, 20 minutes or so. She's all gonna be always open. So I'm taking 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 here, down to 6. We could definitely be dead here. This is gonna have Taunt, and we're gonna get to check the board a little bit, but if they have, what's that card? It deals damage randomly assigned. Wow, that's good. That's gonna make it harder to keep the board in check. Well, I guess the fact that they're attacking into my board makes me feel real good. It means they probably don't have Avenging Wrath or other forms of Reach. Yeah, the fact that they elected to trade their board into mine feels really good here, I think. Yeah, I wonder, like, their hand must be terrible, right? Like, their hand just has to be a bunch of, like, terrible shaman spells for this line that they're taking to make sense. That's a great draw. Give your minions taunt. Yes, please. Taunt means I can just go upstairs, right? I think this trade's good. I think I want to eat the 2-2 even 2 here. Yeah, I think I just want to control the board. I think with this card and this, we're pretty far ahead here. So it's just like try not to die. This makes a... God, fuck you. Fuck. They already played one of those. Glad I held my ooze. I've got that going for me at least. We get to nail their weapon at least. Your magic shall not save me. What I wish Owl cost 2 mana, then Odd Paladin couldn't have a silence effect. God, these fucking shaman spells. Please be bad. We're just not even gonna be able to beat through their hero power here either, right? Like, the fact that their hero power just, like, double breaks ours, good lord. Reporting for duty. I think that's gonna be a wrap here, yeah. Am I allowed to concede? I've been conceding too early. I am assessing that we have lost. I'm assessing that we have lost. Can I pack it in? Good guy, you may concede. All right, I didn't wanna do it early. Yeah, I agree. When our giant mama got silenced, when Lynessa got told to sit up and sit down and shut up, that was about the time we started losing. Silence definitely feels bad in a Voltron-style deck like this. Uther versus Rexa.
Let the hunt begin. I will fight with honor.
Do I keep all three of these against Hunter? I kind of just want to keep all of these. Sunkeeper's usually pretty good against Hunter. Just, like, don't want him in the opener. that's fair. That's fine. Trade one useless card for another, I suppose. Coining a trap. This has to be Wandering Monster, right? Just like Wandering Monster is the only secret you coin. Yep.
Reporting for duty.
I think I just like sit on my thumbs. I guess I could have, if like I properly identify that like it's Wandering Monster, I think I just take a redraw on this Stonehill Defender, right? I don't think I'm in a position for Tarim to be very good. Bottom girls. This card's real good. This is like an aggro deck, just like aggro decks just like have fits and nightmares about this card, right? Yeah, we're just getting bodied. Hopefully Applebaum's gonna catch us back up here. We have an okay curve here. We have Stonehill Defender plus Knife Juggler to fill in next turn a little bit. A touch. They could have Hunter's Mark here. If they mark this, they get to smash through us a little bit. Like, Mark plus Weapon would be a little bit brutal. Three Wolves, sure. Applebaum's kind of better than Thragtusk in a lot of ways. How do we feel about, like, Knife into Stonehill into Lost in the Jungle? Yeah. Not a piece of candy. If Juggler like lives by some miracle of God, Vinecleaver will be real good next turn, but they just go smash, smash, and then smash, right? And they could have like an Arcane Shot or something like that here. A lot of ways to guarantee this dead. All right, they didn't hit the Anthem one. That's good for us.
For justice.
Smash you, trade, trade. Why is Sunkeeper better there? I guess I'm getting kind of low on health. Play around crushing walls. Yep. Drop this fat mother right in the middle. Yeah, they might be able to aggro us out here. I just talked about it, and I didn't realize they were going to spawn over here, too. Crushing walls me, baby. Do it. Crush me asunder. We're also just dead to kill command. So like kill command plus this. Alrighty. Alright, let's play one more. Let's play one more. Maybe end the night on a high note. Thank you, sir. May I have another? Stop it, Tom. We're fucking dead. Get out of here. Don't stop it. They were like two off lethal. We were at six, okay? We were at six and we were dead. Get out of here. We were going to like three, right? Because we were at six and they were hitting us with the wolf that turn. I guess Rexxar takes away their burn spell. Stop it. Spellbreaker is probably pretty good against Druid. They likely have taunts. I guess this is probably a fine two drop. Just gonna mulligan the seven. I can't use the 5-3 weapon, though. Like, they weren't close to dead, and I had no health to actually use a weapon to contain the board. They were at, like, 30. I get that it was a deal 15. But that was less than half their health. Prince on two is really gross. These kind of suck. Oaken summons. That means Spellbreaker will be real good. Chain gang. That's super annoying. Like that, drawn blessing like that. It's a good assessment. I think I'm just doing that and bumping here and then passing. That seems good for us. I feel like we're in a pretty good spot, especially with the silence in my hand. You are not welcome here. So are they playing? They must be playing, what's it called? Spiteless or Spiteful, right? They dead 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So Stegs is lethal. Repent. Hey, look at that. End on a high note. When in doubt, aggro them out. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap for the day. I'll be back tomorrow morning for a short segment with some magic, and then I'll be back tomorrow evening with a longer magic segment. I'll be back with more Hearthstone on Thursday afternoon. Thanks everyone for the support, for the subs and resubs. Y'all keep me here. And remember, if you miss any of it, it'll all go up on YouTube here momentarily. So peace, folks. Everybody have a good evening or day or afternoon, wherever you're at. Good night, folks.